This is Ultra Vortech for the Atari Jaguar video game system, a Street Fighter style fighting game. This is actually a very good game. A lot of people had compared it to Mortal Kombat at the time, without all the violence of ripping people's hearts out and stomping on it and so forth. The basic idea is you're set in another area, another realm, and basically you just fight a bunch of other guys. Unlike a game like Dragon or Double Dragon 5, these guys have powers. Here you've got the hot chick versus, a hot chick, I like that. And you got guys like Dreadlock, and who's a human, you know, obviously, and the woman who's a human, but you also have others that are from different areas. There's machines and so forth, so they have crazy little weapons that humans wouldn't have. As you can see, this game is actually fairly snazzy. This shows off what the Jaguar could do. Look at it. I mean, it looks very beautiful. It looks like Rayman and games like that that actually took advantage of what the Jaguar could do. If more companies had done this, the Jaguar, and earlier too, I mean, not later, but earlier, the Jaguar might have, you know, might have taken over at the time. But a lot of people had slammed it because they didn't look good, but it's because a lot of the companies were just like porting things to every system at the time. They didn't really care about making it look good. And Ultra Vortech from Beyond Games was one of the games that actually looked nice because they took the time out to have a really good soundtrack, really good graphics, and make it a really good game. Here's a couple other guys that are playing. Another human and a non-human. And this guy, who's Buzzsaw. A Buzzsaw's got... This game's a Buzzsaw, see? It's pretty obvious. There are a couple hidden characters in the game. If you look at the Easter eggs section of the videos, you'll find a couple hidden characters you can play. At the time, this was one of the snazzier looking games. I mean, this is all, I mean, basically, this looked like an arcade game. It blew away anything on any of the other systems, the 16-bit systems of the time, and it's actually a fairly good fighting game to play and fight. Some of the fighting games, like Double Dragon 5 or Dragon, that keep slamming all the time, you just feel like you're just pressing buttons. This one here, there's actually moves, and it feels like you're actually playing the game you're fighting. And it's just like, not like press, that you're actually having a little bit of fun with it. And so when you're playing it, that's one of the considerations to consider, not just what it looks and sounds like, which is great, but also the gameplay, how easy it is, how much fun is it, what the controller's like. And this game is like right, A's right along the whole line, the whole border, all A's. I'm giving this game an A. I almost want to get an A+, but it's just not a system seller because of the name. If it was called Mortal Kombat, it would be an A+, because that would sell a jillion units. So I have to give this an A. There's nothing wrong with it. It's a really, really good fighting game.